जय श्री माता जी। सभी साधकों का, सभी सहयोगी भाई बहनों का ध्यान सत्र में स्वागत करते हैं। सामूहिक बंधन, तीन महामंत्र और श्री गणेश मंत्र। चित्त सहस्त्रार पर कायम रखते हुए थोड़ी देर ध्यान करेंगे। इसी ध्यान की अवस्था में हम श्री माता जी की अमृतवाणी आत्मसात करेंगे।
गुडे, वी आर हियर। टू सेलिब्रेट सहस्त्रार डे it was not very difficult for me to open the sastra because there were so many seekers in this world. Because of course I had studied also the permutations and combinations from which you all are in a way suffering. Also, the time had come. I felt horrible gurus who are really devils are trying to capture all the seekers. I thought it's high time that Sahasrara should be opened up. It was not like Christ's crucifixion by any chance. In those days, one had to do a lot of tapasya, and that's what he went through. But in these modern times, what you know is much more important than what you do. It is such a universal awareness now, because of maybe medias, because of communications, because of traveling, that a human mind knows a lot. It knows so much sometimes that its brain cannot even bear. It is so overloaded with ideas, and also the human mind is all the time anxious to grasp, absorb and retain whatever he thinks is knowledge. But he lacks discretion, so all kinds of things are accumulated in his brain in the modern times, especially with the advent of all these media like television, computers, not a media but it's quite a complicated brain again. The man had to know the technique of all these things very much. And this technique, if he understood, he could do many things, many more things than your forefathers could. Thus materialism started taking its own development in the minds of people. So the curse of human beings at that time was materialism. When I felt that Sahasrara must be opened up. Before that, people were simple, innocent. They all believed in God. They never doubted. And they didn't even seek the truth. This materialism created such a competition among human beings, such hypocrisy, that people started finding out that this is not honest. Materialism is not joy-giving. You can't get peace out of materialism. Just it started developing into their awareness that this is not the end of our achievement. This is not what we have to know. This is not what is going to give us joy and peace. Especially after war, this awareness started growing very much among young people. This is also because now the human awareness had reached the state of the brain. That's how they started knowing better, absorbing better, and retaining better. You take a little child of today, he knows much better than you would have known when you were even 25 years of age. Because he's supposed to know about everything. And thus, there was no movement towards knowing what is the truth. But as this awareness grew more and more, lots of seekers were created on this earth. So many people who never knew they were seekers suddenly became seekers. It's an atmospheric effect, I should say. And thus a new category of people were born, became aware that they have to find out the truth. So it was all simultaneously, according to the time that Sahasrara was to be opened up. And thus this happened. For us Sahayogis, of course, Sahasrara is the biggest event. Or we should say, whatever work all the incarnations have done, all the seers and saints and prophets have done, this is the culminating point. They did it for individuals, but to do for masses, that it should go to every nook and corner of this world, is the ultimate end of all spiritual growth all over, in every religion, through every great incarnations and prophets. What they indicated about future, what they talked about, what you are to know yourself, that you have to find yourself, that you have to become a realized soul, that you should have atma-sakshatkar, that you should be a vali. All these indications, even the Buddhist know that Ma-traya has to come. Ma-traya, Ma is mother three times, Trigunatmika. Even the Greeks had Athena with three powers in her. So all of them have been predicting about this time, and that time came. And that's how I call it the blossom time, and the fruits that are you people. So it is all so much, we can say, in the cosmic cycle of different seasons. This beautiful time has come, and like the wheel of time has to turn and go further, Sahayoga started, of course in a very small way, but has now grown so big all over the world. Here now, there's another thing that has happened, which is rather remarkable. That so far, people used to meditate alone, and maybe one of them might get realization. But there was no phenomena of Amas realization, nor of Amas meditation in those days. They all used to disappear into some nook and corner of a quiet place where they would sit down and meditate. But this Amas realization, Amas meditation, Amas understanding and learning about your being was not even imagined by me, that it would go to such a limit, to such an extent, with leaps and bounds. This year especially, it has taken a very new dimension, I think, everywhere, and all that is negative is being exposed in most of the countries. So this is how, when the Sahasrara opened, the Kundalini started moving towards this divine power, getting connected with it, and was all the time flowing within you when the Nirvikalpa state came. Now when it is coming through the Sahasrara, one has to know that the Sahasrara has to be clean so that the flow of divine power is going, penetrating without any obstacle, without getting impure, without getting into any kind of problems. So to get to that level, to that state, all the Sahayogi, I'm happy to know, are trying to work it out, their own individual meditations also, so that this growth should take place. Thus, you get enlightenment in a full way. But then one must ask why, for what? What's the purpose? What's the aim? The aim is, your aim is lost. If you don't seek for aims at all anymore. This pendal was built with such great ability for which we didn't pay anything. Everybody was working here day and night in the rainy season, and I was quite worried about them. I said, what's the matter? Just, we are enjoying, Mother, we are enjoying. I brought enjoying. We are enjoying the rain, all right. We are enjoying the cold, all right. Enjoying everything, lifting all these heavy things, everything we are enjoying. I was quite surprised at them. Nobody had any complaints, but everybody was just on the warpath, building this tent for them. So what happens? Once your Sahasrara is clean, this flow of joy doesn't allow you even to think that you are exerting or you are working. Normally if you tell somebody that this is to be erected, some would faint and some would say, this will take at least 1 year. Then they'll start giving excuses, this pole is no good, that is no good, it won't stand that, there's nothing, there's nothing. Ultimately you'll find nothing is done. it will lie like this for years together. You better get another person, you better buy another one. Everything is postponed all the time and nothing is done. But here you don't feel you are doing anything. When you don't feel you are doing anything, how can you say then why? Because I'm not doing anything in any way, so I don't ask question why, do I? In any case, I'm not doing anything. That is the state where you are working in the divine plan. You are doing lot of work, but nobody feels they are doing anything. They all think we are absolutely just enjoying ourselves, doing nothing. This kind of a state is the blessing of Sahasrara. Because only in your brain you think all these things, labor-saving devices. I mean, you tell anybody, you go and telephone to this person. Immediately, if it's a madman, he'll say, he may not be there, God knows, what's the use, telephone may not be all right. Baba, you see. Why don't you see if the telephone is all right or not? Before that only he will give his 101 explanations that it may not be all right, it may be something may be wrong. And just labor-saving first. That is one of the tricks of the brain. Then this intelligence cheats all the time. It gives you rationality for everything. Like a person kills his father. You ask him, why did you kill? Why not? He was so old, he was suffering, and I wanted to have all the property, so I thought better kill him. Like Queen Victoria became very old, so her son was to think that I'll never become a king if this lady goes on like this. So the brain starts giving lots of explanation and cheating. Because rationality. It gives rationality, and rationality is nothing but ego or your conditioning. Your ego tells you, no, this is no good. So you stick on to that point, this is not good. Then another can ask you why it is not good. I think it is not good, so I think. Or like some say, I believe, but why? But in Sahaja Yoga, answer is simple. Why do you do it? I enjoy it. What's the next answer? Why are you worried? I'm enjoying it. Now the people who also say like that, because of their conditionings, oh, I'm enjoying it. Somebody will say, I enjoy my drink. Somebody can say, I enjoy my going to the church. Something else, it's like that. They are enjoying something, which according to Sahaja Yoga, we can never enjoy. But that enjoyment is not collective. That is not supported by anyone. For example, somebody says, I enjoy drinking. Nobody has erected any temple or any statue of a man who drinks. Have you seen anywhere in the whole world? So though he may say that I enjoy, it has no sanction from the society. People can say, I enjoy stealing, people can say, I enjoy killing, but it is very arbitrary, it is very individual and never supported by the society, even by the modern society. And there's always reaction to it. But Sahaja Yoga is not like that. When you say, I enjoy, you say it because you have no ego and you have no conditionings. It's a different situation. Because now the Sahasrara is opened. So on one side your ego has gone down, another side your conditioning is finished. You are no more conditioned. Like you talk to a Catholic. So I started talking about Christ. Immediately said, "Mother, now please." I said, "I am talking about Christ, not about Catholicism. Talking of Christ, why are you frightened about? Mother, we shouldn't become Catholic again, you know, that's why we are worried about. Baba, Christ never started Catholicism. So much so, they have developed a kind of a deconditioning of their minds. That they start seeing that whatever these people have done so far was wrong. And that whatever I have done so far was absolutely wrong and I'm not going to do it. It's a very common thing. I have seen the people who have worshipped Christ prefer to worship Ganesha. And those who have worshipped Ganesha prefer to worship Christ. Just the same. The name is different, but just the same. But they like it. Because Christ means the priest, the confessions, rosaries, and also symmetries. So they don't want to have. These conditionings itself start showing their own forms, like devils, and such yogis want to avoid, or have nothing to do with them. I remember in the beginning, we had about 6-7 hippies from England, and they had come to Rahuri. We were having a program. And there were 5-6 real hippies. These were hippies became sadyogis. Real hippies came to the program. I was just sitting like this and suddenly they said, "Oh no!" I said, "What has happened?" I started. As if some snake has entered or what has happened. They were hippies. But with this deconditioning of the conditions, they just couldn't bear those same hippies that they were coming inside. Because you start seeing clearly, very clearly, that all these conditionings had blinded us completely and it's misled us into a wilderness. Of course, about ego, in the West people are extremely conscious. There was a leader's wife. I said, "Why don't you help your husband?" She said, "Mother, I am worried about my ego." I said, "Why?" "If I start doing some work, this ego might develop again, so I am rather worried." They are so conscious of it that this ego should not come back. One fellow who came to me and I was talking to him, then he just ran away. I said, "What happened?" She said, "No, those people who go close to mother always develop very bad ego. I don't want to be there close for with her." So, it's such a mind that sees madness, that sees insanity, that sees immaturity, it sees vulgarity, it sees deceit, hypocrisy, everything so clearly. And in that state he gets confused and quite upset, wants to run away from it. Then we have some sadyogis who have such problems, who come to sadyoga with problems. Then these people see them with these problems, they are still continuing. Now the sastrara doesn't want to accept it. It's terrible. I was like him. No more. Me, I don't want to be that. So they abhor the person who was just like them. They just can't bear him. They just can't tolerate. Then I would say, still, you have to grow. You have to grow. Your sastrara has to be cleansed out at such a speed, at such a level and stage that like soap cleanses everything, it should cleanse everything else, should not be afraid of anything, should not have any worry about the conditionings of others or ego of others. That is the state now we have to reach. Today is the Sahasrara day, is the 23rd Sahasrara day. And I shouldn't expect much. I don't want to say anything much about it. But I wish and I hope that all the 1,000 petals of your Sahasraras will be so cleansed that you will never catch from anybody, you will never be frightened of anybody, you will be masters of all kinds of curatives, and also you will be the one who can give solace, peace to others. You will be the one who will be organizing programs outside. You will be the one who will be responsible for Sahaja. And when that happens, then we can see that these 1,000 petals of the Sahasrara have opened out. These 1,000 petals are not yet awakened. They signify the different 1,000 powers of the Goddess, minimum of minimum. These 1,000 ones you can open out yourself by introspection, by looking at yourself, making fun of yourself. Know thyself means know yourself with all the defects you have and also the potential you have and all the good points you have. So as far as you are concerned, when you are looking at yourself, you should just see to the defects that you have. Why do I behave like this? Why do I assert so much? What's the problem? Why can't I see myself clearly? With that transparency of your Sahasrara, you can see your heart, you can see your mind, you can see yourself fully, clearly. What's wrong with you? This transparency can come only if you have really the pure desire, Shuddha Ichcha, to be of that level. Now there is no competition between A and B. We don't say that you got the first prize for coming out of the Sahasrara. Or we don't say you have the second prize. There's nothing like first, second in Sahaja Yoga. Because we are not running the race. There's no competition between us. Whatever we are doing is for our own satisfaction. Now think of something. There are 5 people who are running. Now they have to think out of these 5 people who goes first. Here it is the other way now. The 5 people are meditating. Now everyone individually has to see for himself if he satisfies himself or not. Nobody else is going to give a certificate. It is you who has to give certificate to yourself, honestly. It's a very different position. It is you, your Sahasrara, and your attention. And you have to see within yourself, how far have I realized my own powers, my own compassion, my own personality. You will have to test it yourself. It is who you are, the one who decides. When you are the one who is running, it is you are the one who decides without running, then what is the question of competition? The whole thing disappears into nothing. As I told you the other day, an analogy, that if you are looking at the mirror, then you are the one who is observing. Your reflection is the one that is observed, and there is the action of seeing. So you are in three dimension. But supposing you become the mirror yourself, the whole process is reversed. You see yourself, you don't have to see because you are seeing it all the time. It's just spontaneous. In the same manner, when it comes to Sahasrara, it is your Sahasrara itself gives you the full idea as to how you are. The diagnosis comes from your own Sahasrara. Your own Sahasrara tells you what centers are catching, because all the pithas of the seven centers are in the Sahasrara. As if the Sahasrara is now watching yourself and reporting to you, see, this is wrong with you, this is wrong with you, this is wrong with you. So, Sahasrara, being the best well-wisher that you have, gives you the right information about yourself. So the best is that you correct yourself. So then achieve that perfect state. That is what you have to do. But once you have achieved the perfect state, you have achieved your aim, you have no aim left. Like the lights now. Till you have to make the lights, you have to work hard. Make the lights, put them right, do everything that is necessary. But once it is made and the light comes into it, then the job of the light is to give the light. So the first function is over. Now the second function is to give it back. You reach your aim, your destination. For example, I had to come here, all right? So I come all the way from my house, come in the car, walk in and come and sit down here. Now it's finished, that part. Over. Now I don't have to walk. Otherwise I'll be all the time running. So all this mad race of this brain stops. For what? Should it be used now? For enjoying the peace, for enjoying the joy, for enjoying the collectivity. So the labor or the hard work, or you can also say the planning of the future, finishes off. Only thing, now you have got it, so better enjoy it. It's like you are coming from outside, you are running, you are very hungry, you want to reach home. Once you reach home, then the food is served to you. Now what's your aim? Nothing. but to enjoy the food for which you are running. But after that also if you start running, then one should say, it is absolute stupidity. But the capacity of enjoyment only comes when your sahasrara is absolutely open. Otherwise, the capacity to enjoy is much less. And you become like a person who is running all the time after something which you never achieve. There are many like that. All their lives they are like mad, you know. They are working morning till evening, every day, achieving nothing. Next day again get up, again running. All their lives running like this. Till their foot is in the grave, they are still running. But after getting to Sajva, you stop all these activities and leave it to your Sajoga to work, to your Sahasrara to work it out. And it works out. You don't have to rush, you don't have to be so competent, you don't have to write down everything, you don't have to think of planning everything. Just everything works out. And it works out beautifully. The only thing that one has to do is to accept whatever is happening for our good. Even in small, small things. For today's delay in the puja is the desire of some people who wanted to give you some sort of a, I shouldn't say that, but some secret show was going to be there. And they didn't want any light. So they were thinking, what will happen? The puja will be over by about 5, then by 6 o'clock they'll eat their food, but the sun would be there after 9 o'clock. Then how can we show this? All right? So have it in the night. Every small thing you will see. Some people were coming from India and they had to bring my 2 boxes from there. And they wouldn't allow these boxes. They said it is overweight, overweight. So they didn't know what to do. They thought that they should send them back and later on it can go till Guru Puja or somewhere. But they thought that there must be some plan, must be some drama. The plane was late 19 hours. So they thought there must be some drama. And then they were put into some sort of a tourist hotel for that night. Next morning they met 2 other Indians from Sahyogis from Pune. 2 boys. That settled it. My luggage, they could put it in their name. And that's how the luggage came in. But they never felt bored, 19 hours. We had nice time with that together, we were enjoying and talking, finished. Nobody feels that time is passing out, otherwise anybody else would have eaten up all the airport personnel and would have broken all the telephones. Waiting for 19 hours, my God, what is this? Would have given it in the newspapers, everyone. It's the greatest crime. While these were enjoying life nicely. So, we have lost now the sense of aim. We don't have any aims. We just want to enjoy. It's a very, very big thing that has happened. Because, as you know, the joy in the sahasrara is Nirananda. Nirananda. Of course, Nira is my name also. But it means pure, absolute joy. Nirananda. And that Nirananda, that joy, has no other use. It's just pure, pure joy. without thinking, it just pours into it. After all, every activity is for what? For getting some sort of a pleasure, sensation, and also some people believe for joy. It's not. Only after the opening of Sahasrara and the cleansing of it, then you know what is joy. You can't explain how you can spend hours together like this. People don't understand. Like even our mayor was telling me that we can't sit in the church for more than 15 minutes. And how people are sitting here for so many hours. 15 minutes we cannot sit, but how these people are sitting for such a long time? What are they doing there? What is their entertainment? How can they sit for hours together? Without saying anything, without dropping even a pin, they are just all the time there. So what have we given them? What is happening to them? This is very surprising and remarkable, that these people who are not even sadhus can see clearly that you people are least bothered, you are absolutely enjoying life. Whatever you may be doing is not important. What is important is that whether you are working in the office or outside, you are full of joy, enjoying everything. This is the most important thing in life, which you can have only through sadhuga. Because your sastraras are open. Because they are open. There is now one more thing I have to tell you that is very important for all of you to remember. That while living in this ocean of joy, we have to remember that there are many who have not yet jumped into it. So we have to bring them in. And it's such a pleasure, such a joy to give realization to someone. Extremely joyful. So we need people who would come and say that we definitely come for this. They should really come forward. And once they come forward, you'll be amazed how things will work out. There are many I know who are going all over, everywhere, and spreading sadhuga. So it's very important for all of you to know that you have got the light to be given to others. Come forward. Don't have fear of your ego, conditionings, nothing. Come forward. You have all the strength, you have everything within yourself, and you will do everything with such happiness and joy. Everywhere in every country people are doing that, but some of them are doing, some of them are not doing. All of you are quite capable of doing it, so please come forward and see for yourself what you are capable of. First of all, you should have faith in yourself. If you have no faith in yourself, you cannot do anything. Have faith. You should have no fears of any kind. And also to introspect, to see within yourself what's going on. To be very frank, I find my brain absolutely empty. What I talk from this emptiness, I don't know. You will also find your brain absolutely empty. And still, with that empty brain, you will be achieving a lot. It's very remarkable, as you have seen, that from the candle you get cool breeze. How can you get from the candle cool breeze? You do get. So it's important to recognize yourself as a sadhyogi and to recognize what have you done for sadhuga. Without doing for sadhuga, you cannot enjoy life. That was your aim. And that's the aim you have reached. Now, if you don't Supposing I have to come and sit on this thing and I don't sit on this thing, then what's the use of coming here? I came here to tell you something about Sahasrara. And if I don't tell you, then what's the use of my coming here and celebrating Sahasrara Day? In the same way, when you have reached that state now, what you have to do is not to use for your own purpose. You have used it quite a lot for your health, wealth, everything. Now, what are we doing about Sahaja Yoga? What have we done for Sahaja Yoga? After some time, you will do a lot and you will never know you have done anything for Sahaja Yoga. Very surprising it happens to so many of you and should happen to all of you. I hope all of you will realize that your sastras are clean, completely, you are perfectly all right, you don't have to worry about it and you can really go ahead with spreading of Sahaja Yoga. May God bless you all.
जय श्री माता जी। परम पूज्य श्री माता जी के पावन चरणों में प्रार्थना अर्पित करते हैं। परम पूज्य श्री माता जी कृपावंत होकर हमें ऐसी स्थिति प्रदान कीजिए कि हमारे हृदय में सभी के लिए प्रेम की भावना हो, क्षमा और करुणा की भावना हो, सभी के लिए हमारे हृदय में असीम प्रेम भर दीजिए। परम पूज्य श्री माता जी हमारे व्यक्तित्व से, हमारे जीवन से यही प्रेम परावर्तित हो और जो भी हमारे संपर्क में आए वे इसी प्रेम से आलोकित हो और आनंदित हो, ऐसी स्थिति कृपा कर हमें प्रदान कीजिए। परम पूज्य श्री माता जी संपूर्ण समर्पण की भावना आप कृपा कर हम में भर दीजिए। तव पाद पद्मी माता सर्वम समर्पयामि, इस तरह की स्थिति कृपावंत होकर आप हमें प्रदान कीजिए। जय श्री माता जी। सामूहिक बंधन। Oh, आज का ध्यान संपन्न होता है। जय श्री माता जी।